Welcome to episode 5 of Evoland, and when I left you last, we were now loading. I decided that I was going to go and do a bunch of crazy grinding, and I got a bunch of money, so let's look at that. I've got 20,000 glees. I'm also level 12. Let me just show you what I did very quickly before I forget about that. Okay. So I went out here. Out the back. And there's all this purple waste around. Well, it's not purple. And I got into a fight. Okay. These potted plants, no problem. But you're gonna notice one immediate thing. I'm gonna attack them. They're gonna do a whole lot of damage to me. Like, crazy amounts of damage. And to get this right, basically I was dying sometimes because it would put up to 4 guys on the screen at the same time. But that gets me 340 glees and 12 XP, whereas going the other way around would have been a lot safer, but it would have taken me a lot longer to get the glees to get the currency. So I'm gonna save quickly because I got a little more money. We're gonna run this way. You can get sort of mini achievements by doing that. There are enemies, I'll show you later, that you can smack around that give you little mini achievements. But I'm gonna buy some stuff. So we're gonna buy the rare card, because I promised I would do that. That's the Amulet King. We're gonna buy the fast DVD player. No more loading screens. We won't regret you. And I'm gonna buy the soul armor. Okay, my defense has increased. It doesn't look like it has, but it has. It will make a whole lot of difference. The other thing I said I was going to do was we're going to play friendly game at Double Twin. Now, I went and tested this out. With the cards that we have at the moment, we can do some of it. We're not going to be able to do all of it, so I'm going to do what I can, and we're going to die probably. But we'll see what we can get. Okay, so we're gonna go easy. Double Twin is pretty simple, really. You have these cards, okay? They have 4 sides, and on each side they've got a number. So it's like, you have a look at what you have, and you see, okay, he's got a bunch of 3s, so in that case, 4 might be to 3. So the best thing to play is to play a 4, because... And you want to play it here, not here, because this would expose the bottom 3 to whatever he has. So we're going to put that down there. And as a result, because my number, his 4 and my 2, mine is better, so I win. Okay, let's try that again. With less fail this time. Yes, easy. That was me and I was being silly, so... Sometimes that happens. Okay, this is pretty good. 2, 2, 3. We'll go up in little escalators. Oh, that's a good card. See, it sometimes randomly deals you the good cards like this. I'm inclined to do this, though. Because this is up by small increments. Okay, what's he gonna do? Oh, he's gonna make it go with 7. Okay, so I've got nothing that beats a 7 downward. So what I'm gonna try and do is put a guy who's kind of the middle of the road in here, so I don't waste the 9. You wanna try and probably hold onto your big cards until you can't anymore. So I'm gonna go with a 4 here. See what he does. 4s, that's all pretty good. I'm happy with that. Now, the thing is that one of the things I can do here is I can put a pretty strong card down there. And that will stop him from not being able to take that. The other thing I can... Actually, this is better. There. Let's see what he does. Oh, okay. So... I kind of want to save this. Well, there's no real point, I guess. What we'll do is this forward by small increment there. And you won't be able to capture anything necessarily. Yep, there we go, so we win. And of course, this is just, card player, you have won a game of Double Twin. We're gonna go and do medium quickly. Just the same basic thing. He gets better cards, though. As you go along, he gets better cards. So you can see the quality of his cards is increasing a little bit here. And I don't have anything to beat him. Really. I've got that. And so I think what I'm going to do, we'll stick to making moderately small gains there. Okay. He will probably... Oh, well, that's interesting. I think the best thing to do would be to do this, because it puts a 7 up, and I don't think he will be able to beat a 7. What's he gonna do? Oh, okay, good. Alright. So, now, the choice is to go and try and beat the 5, or to beat the 4, but I've got one card that will beat the 5, and that's this, whereas, well, it's basically this or bust looking at it, so we're going to put this down. He's probably going to be able to take one of them back. Oh, no he can't. Okay, that's good. Okay. And we win. Right. And this is the last convincing win that we're gonna get. I played around with hard for a little while, and I won once. I'm gonna try it now, and we'll see how we go, but I don't think we're gonna win hard. So we're going to move on with a quest quickly, right. I had that bomb thing, right. So for the bombs, we need to go talk to the old lady. Okay, so let's head on up here. This is a bit of a rigmarole because she sends you on a run around. Ah! I didn't mean to do that. Sorry. Where are you? There. Bombs, you say? Yes, I have some in my cellar. There have been years since the war, but I'm almost certain they will still work just fine. Let me give them to you if you do something for me, of course. You see, a dragon has been attacking the countryside, leaving only charred guard behind it. We need to get rid of this mighty beast. Deputy Raylan was on patrol duty this week. He should be able to tell you more. You will find him at the country entrance of the village. I almost said he was in the countryside. Aha! Okay, so Raylan is over here. I'm gonna run. I can see this is going to be the faffing about episode again. The dragon? Well, I don't think anyone really saw a dragon, but I didn't see marks on the ground. Big round craters of charger. I even had to tell the kid to get away from the village. Yeah, tell the kid to get back to the village. I always see him playing around the craters. You can't let children play near a dragon. You should talk to his mother, who lives in the house next to Sid's. So we'll go to the house next to Sid's. And you can see kind of how this is going. Also, notice now, no more loading screens. Haha! Okay. You're old enough to know dragons don't exist, right? That damn kid must have stolen the bombs from the old lady's cellar. I thought those firecrackers were just a bit too big and heavy. Tell him to give you the bombs. I just hope they'll be safer in your hands. Okay, so, the kid, I keep on doing this because I keep on thinking I can get to the well from there, but I can't. Oh well. Haha, did you see what I did there? So, here's the kid, and you talk to the kid, and he goes, ah, he pushes you around. Great. Come here. Hey, kid. What is it? Well, okay, no. I don't want to do that. I just want to talk to the kid. Come on. How hard is this? There. My mother knows about the bombs. I'm in so much trouble. But it was so fun. It was probably worth it. Can I at least keep one? And here comes Karis. Clink! I learned a powerful spell! Did you find the bombs? And so you did. Handle with care. That's a good piece of advice. Karis, great! Let's head to the Sacred Grove south of here. Now, the thing about the Sacred Grove, okay? There's no time to waste. We may end up doing the Sacred Grove in two pieces. Okay, so we're gonna save. Because the Sacred Grove is fairly extensive. While we're running over to the Sacred Grove, this is probably my favorite part of the game. I'm gonna leave this fight in because I wanna show you what she learned. Okay, so Clink hits. Aww. Oh well. So much for that. Let's see if we can get into another battle. There we go. Ah, okay, better. Right, so what did Karis learn? She learned magic. X-Crystal. There's no mana points in this game. None. So you can spam this all day long, right? So X-Crystal. Now she actually hits. Okay. Oh, oops. I keep forgetting. Magic, extra soul. Go. Okay. Oh, our magic is increased. That doesn't really do anything for us. I think I might put up her damage. Now, this is one of my favorite parts of this game. And this is the reason why I want to show you this. Okay, so we're going to put the bomb down. Boom, the bomb blows everything sky high. Okay, we need to swap back to our weapon. Okay, we can't go there because there's the tree in the way. Which turns out to be a bit of a problem. But then you come across, well, hang on. You come across these crystals, okay? And remember how Karis was going on about, oh, the crystal will make you change your perspective on everything? Bam. You got time travel. Hit the crystal switch between past and present, Marty. Hey, that's awesome. So now, because this is 2D, you can simply run over here. Okay, so there's this thing and you don't know what to do with that. You're gonna hit that. And of course now, because you're in 2D, 3D, these blocks are flat and you can run over them all day long. So, we need to head on down here. And hey look, it's a cavern of gink. Okay. It's much like the cavern in Noria Mines. You gotta be careful of where you step, otherwise you'll die. I didn't think we could go all the way. That's too bad. There's this chest in the middle that we're going to try and go after. As you can see, we can't because the chest is obscured. And running up here doesn't actually help. Oh. Nope, not there either. Let's go here? No. And here. Ah, okay. Secret over here. This is an invisible wall. You just run until you can't run anymore, and then you go through. Oh, incidentally, at some point we're gonna have to go back to the Noria mines, but we're not gonna do it quite yet, because we're too busy doing other stuff. We need one more item before we can go back to the Noria mines. Yeah. Ah! Aw, I'm sorry. That wasn't supposed to happen. I did not collect the chest because I'm silly. But this is just a star or a card. Yeah, it's a star. This particular area has lots of stars. Actually, hang on. I think the way I'm supposed to be going is here. No? I could have sworn it was. Maybe? Ah. Chest. Important chest, by the way. Because it gives you the bow. Okay, so you'd think you could just go straight, but you can't. Because that's going to kill you. So, we're going to go our friend a long way around. Okay, perfect. Right, so now we're out. And the bow is really pretty important because it's going to help us a lot. Okay. Oh, that's always good. I'm going to go out of here. Okay. Now, because the tree's here, we can't get back that way. Because we're in 3D. We need to go here, hit this. Now we're in 2D again. And this is probably the most awesome part of the game because of the... And you can see that it says, don't burn small trees. But that's going to be important. We're going to go back to sword. Just because of the flipping from 2D to 3D, this is probably my favorite section of this game. Okay, so we go through here. Okay, so here's a tricky thing. There's a little tree here and it doesn't look like you're going to be able to get there. But if you're smart, you leave a bomb there, and you can make it across just in time. Ah! Okay, that was a mistake, but it's fine. Gonna grab what's in here. And we're gonna get Kafka's Ghost, which is another card. Okay, so now, because the tree's in the way, right? We're gonna wanna hit this, and then we're gonna put a bomb down. We're gonna wanna go here, and we're just in time, and now we can go across. Right. Ow. Hey, what are you doing? That's mean and rude. Okay, I need to be 2D so I can get here. Okay, so, what you need to do here, this is a burning pit, right? The thing about the burning pits is that you can't actually do anything with the burning pits while they're there. So what you... Well, you can't do anything with the unlighted pits. You gotta take your arrow, shoot it across, and it becomes a fire arrow. And then again, like before, you shoot this. Now you can get through here at all. Perfect. Okay, so now we're gonna run over here. There's a blowable rock. One of the good design things about this game is they didn't actually constrain you with regards to having bombs. Because you have as many bombs as you need. Why am I not able to go through there? I thought it was there. Okay. I could have sworn that would be the way to get through there. Confused? I am. Okay, hold on. Maybe I need to approach it from somewhere else. Maybe I need to come from here. Oh, you can also get... Actually, let's try and do that quickly. You can get a little achievement thingy. There we go. Exterminator, you blew up something with a bomb. I thought I could get... Oh, wait, you know what? I can get it. No? I could have sworn I could get that. Oh, well. That's mean and rude. Thanks, I'll take that. And we'll blow up this rock. That's going to be important later. I keep forgetting that I don't... It's not automatically switching you between your weapon and the bomb, so I keep on making this mistaken impression that I am in bomb mode when I'm really not. Here we go. Let's let all these guys out. Seems awesome, right? Ow! And there we go. Okay, let's go grab this. And this is why I say we're going to probably want to have this over two sessions. I am going to shoot this. Actually, let's just do a blowout. We'll finish this off. Because there's one short thing I want to show you quickly. I don't know how short it will be, but... You can also instantly blow up these Octo-Oct guys with a bomb. There we go. Okay. That looks like it's kind of going to be a problem. I mean, how do you get fire there? But, as per always, you take your... Let's see now. Yeah, take... I don't have my sword out, do I? Yeah, I do. Okay, go ahead. Do this. Kill that, kill that. Blow up a little area here. Let it up while that's happening. Let's clear this up here. Okay, so here's probably one of the biggest meter puzzles going on in this section. And this is easily one of my favorite things about this. We've seen all those little unlighted areas way down south, and we can't do anything about them. Way up north, I should say. So what you do is you come over here, and you clear out all the stray stuff happening over here. Like over here, and we're gonna need to get back that way. If there's one bad thing about this particular area, it's this current bit that I'm in, because there's a lot of throwing and throwing. So what you do is you've got that all hollowed out. You shoot upward, and you can hit that with your arrow. Time travel, you switch 12 times between past and present. Okay, so now, with that all set up, oh wait, I can't, I keep forgetting. I'm a little dumb. I need to be in the past. Because I need to get past the small tree. There we go. Oh, wait, actually. If I'm real smart, I'll make my life easier for later. Let's burn down the small tree. So now we can go in 3D all the way up here. I really love this because it's a clever use of the mechanics that the guys set up. Okay, so now we have this statue, this particular bit all lit up. We need to get this particular bit all lit up. Okay, we're gonna blow up this. Okay. And now, let's just see if I remember this rightly. We need to go here. This crystal is inactive. The amulet should be enough to power it. Oh, I didn't think that would be a problem. Oh well. So I need to be in two dimensions. Oh god, this is gonna be super tedious. Cause I need to run all the way back to the area I was in. Yeah, okay, there. That's the only problem with this, this long run here, because there is only just one crystal. Yeah. Let's get going over this way. Okay. Now, we need to get that thing lit, okay? And the only way to get that thing lit is to go over here. And fire from this particular section here. So we're gonna light that up. And presto. We have the amulet. But the only thing I'm struggling to remember now is how to light this section. I'm gonna go grab the amulet very quickly. Because grabbing the amulet really isn't a problem. And then I'm gonna come out of here. And I'm gonna head out of the current section we're in, because I need to call an episode. We've already gone way over time, and I didn't mean for that to happen. But that's what happens when you play double twin. Tee hee. Okay, so. Right, I'm gonna grab the amulet very quickly. Amulet's down here. I wanna be here. Let's kill you. Oh, and you. Push the sky. And that gate should open. Now, this is scary room of doom. It turns out though, and this is kind of funny. You can do that, and it will actually kill these guys. Oh god, that was unpleasant. Ow. That annoying sound. I may die here. I'm gonna die. Okay, I'm gonna call that an episode right there. Sorry, folks. In the next episode, I'll definitely go in, and the first thing we'll do is we'll go and grab the amulet, but we're way over time, and that was silly on my behalf. Thank you so much for watching. This has been episode 5 of evoland. I've been Lostwolfe, and I hope you're enjoying it as much as I am. Thanks for watching, folks. Have a great week, and goodbye.